painting, how we should construct a painting, what is the difference between a masterpiece and an ordinary art, how we make our art better, how we make people understand our works, how we present them, how they should, how we, the artist should explain their artwork, what all is to be done. So basically, we'll be just touching the surface. We are not going very deep into the subject. Hindi translations are available if somebody wants to go through them. So when we are being creative, we take the earthly material, its colors made of clay, plants, its stones and marbles, and infuse them with ideas. An artist is, or rather, should constantly seek new ways of bringing the ideals of the invisible world into the form of matter. We must mold nature according to our own understanding. A true artist, or an artist's goal, should always be to go beyond matter, physicality, physical, beyond appearances. For example, a rose may be a beautiful flower, yet when the artist paints it, he tries to infuse it with a quality of ideal to reveal what is perfect within the form. He breathes into it a living spirit, which is why since the very earliest days of Renaissance period, the artists have been likened and linked to God. Artists are charged with the strange destiny of reminding other people that the world is more than the outer forms of nature might suggest. This is why the great German Goethe, a writer, insisted that art was a separate creative kingdom made by a man in which nature finds its own completion and perfection. Art has many faces, many layers, which are perhaps confusing for those who have not yet seen underlying unity. Not just laymen, but even artists sometimes do not understand others or their own creations. Yet, once the truth is seen and understood, one finds delight in many aspects of art. In the varieties of techniques, methods of composition, the language of color, when we understand how to see or perceive art, the pleasure is something higher than mere norms and forms. So today we will try to understand the paintings of some great masters. But before that, the main question that comes to mind is, how does a picture become a work of art? Art, said a famous painter, Walter Sickert, just happens. Just ho jata. What he probably meant by that was when art just goes beyond the stage of planning, sab kar liya, scheme of colors, compositional geometry, drawing of forms, and after that, magic happens. If he is a fine artist, he infuses something personal, something extra in the work, the X factor. This mystic ingredient, which no artist allows with his conscious mind, but which just happens because of his genius or artistic talent. It is this important element in art that, if it happens, gives a creative spark, which is not easy to define, but is very visible to viewers and senses. You just feel it. That is why when we stand in front of great masters' works in the museums, we are spellbound and learning something new. There is an enormous gap between a really great art and an ordinary one. Regular visits to art galleries and museums really helps. Sadly, in current scenarios, the artworks are cramped in small places with no justice to one particular one. Ideally, viewers need to spend a one-to-one quality time with the artwork to immerse in its sense. Ideally, one should not look at more than 4 or 5 paintings, and one should be prepared to spend a lot of time with each one. A painting goes on. First thing I would like to emphasize upon is to think and work upon an idea. All art ideally technique of painting is. It is the screen by Edward Munch, German painter, one of the most expensive. A button home screen is really done that nobody sees the films. So I just wanted to show the journey. So I wanted to specifically show his earlier works. Pehle ki kaam hai ji. So aur bhi kaam hai. So ye hai ki aap thoda sa study kar lijiye ki color combinations or compositions are perfect and this is fine. Right? So he knows what he's doing. He's understood. He started straight and then he went to that. Here. So, मैंने अभी मैं इसे थोड़ा सा वो करा है तो अभी आपको हम इसको सही करें. आई चोज दिस फॉर स्पेशली फॉर कॉम्पोजिशन.
Their prices, the price
in this world. oranges to paint the area of the cafe and surrounds this with a lonely blue outside. Baki sab blue hai, sirf red and yellow. Aapko blue colors dikh rahe hain, green sab blue. This circular tops of the blue tables are not only intended to contrast very powerfully with the orange around them, intensifying the feeling of warmth, but also suggest through their color and shapes a connection with the stars in the sky. Aap table top dekhe aur stars dekhe, wo balance kya? Color se. Same color. Is considered among early modernist of 20th century Indian art. This masterpiece has his iconic style, badam or almond-shaped eyes. जो बहुत से लोगों को कॉपी भी करते हैं, this was his, he was the first one to use his signature style. This work is inspired by the folk traditional art of Bengal. Vibrant colors, bold lines, and minimal detail. In this work, we see an example of harmony and balance, self-expressions, style, and the oval shape of the face. Balance is achieved by the placement of puja thali in hands, which is exact shape as the neck of the ladies. जो गर्दन है और पूजा की थाली है और तो same shape है, तो उन्होंने वहाँ से balance किया. All have similar jewelry and features which give us a very trance-like look. एक जैसा ही लगता है, सबकी एकदम same look है, same feel है. His approach towards minimalism and treatment can be seen in the border of the sari with horizontal brush work or just the dots to depict the design of the sari work. बहुत कम hard image. Shapes of the eyes and thali is similar. This kind of treatment shows the mastery of the artist. Everything here is composed very carefully and painted in same manner. Do not miss the skin tone given to one pujari to balance out the work. तीनों देख रहे हैं आप, पर तीनों में से एक पुजारी का कलर का टोन अलग है. बाकी से नहीं. अगर वो तीनों को देते थे तो वो इम्पैक्ट ही नहीं पड़ता. सो सब बहुत सोच समझ के किया उन्होंने. Because of this, the focus remains on the central figure. क्योंकि उन्होंने उनको डार्क दिया, इसलिए हमारा फोकस हमेशा सेंटर में रहता है. इसको सेंटर में लाने के लिए उन्होंने उसको डार्क कर दिया. This work is done in gouache टेक्निक. ये फ्रेंच टेक्निक होती है, जस्ट लाइक पोस्टर कलर्स, वाटर कलर्स और पोस्टर कलर्स का मिक्स होता है. ही हैज यूज्ड इंडिगो कलर फॉर द मेन पुजारी साड़ी. व्हाई? Indigo color is an important historic reference to the uprising of indigo farmers of Bengal against the British government. In those times, British ki hamare upar kabza tha bharat ka. So ye kind of artist ki statement thi. So ek artist kisi bhi cheez ke against bol sakta hai apne kaam ki taraf wajah se. So artist uses brush to show his inclinations and thoughts and forever imprinted his mark in the history of it. And ironically, this work has